Good day to Dinarians on the go and in the know, October 27, 2019, no hype, no BS, just the facts. Hit the like and subscribe button so you don't miss out on my next post. I encourage you, knowledge is power, stay informed and stay alert, and know that today, we are one day closer than yesterday. First article of interest, U.S. official. Baghdadi's body was identified by DNA analysis, 27 October, 2019. A senior U.S. military source confirmed on Sunday the death of SIS Eater Bubi Akr al-Adadi FTER. He was identified by DNA analysis in the U.S. raid in Syria's Idlib province. The network quoted the official as saying that 50 to 70 soldiers and 6 helicopters took part in the raid that targeted al-Baghdadi, noting that U.S. forces that participated in the raid on Adadi launched from Erbil. He pointed out that Baghdadi is killed when he detonated his explosive vest, stressing that was identified Adadi-wide DNA analysis. The analysis of Baghdadi's DNA took a day and the results confirmed his identity, he said. The Reuters news agency quoted a senior Turkish official as saying that Adadi is killed in the early hours of Sunday morning, about 48 hours before the operation. He added that the Turkish army had prior knowledge of the U.S. operation in the Syrian province of Idlib, and that Turkey would continue to coordinate its movements on the ground with the parties concerned. A U.S. official told CNN that Turkey did not play any role in assisting the operation, but the non-engagement was coordinated with the Turkish army. Next article of interest. Demonstrations continue in Baghdad amid cautious security calm. October 27, 2019, 10:05:17 p.m. Baghdad range. Hundreds of protesters gathered on Sunday in Tahrir Square in central Baghdad, in a new challenge after a long night of demonstrations by demonstrators demanding to topple the regime used security forces to disperse tear gas. Iraqis continued to rally despite the death toll exceeded 60 in the second wave of anti-government protests that began on Thursday evening. Some were shot dead, some with tear gas and others burned during the burning of political party headquarters. "We went out to sack the government," said one protester, who wrapped his head with an Iraqi flag. Iraqi Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi and Parliament Speaker Mohammed al-Albasi made several proposals to implement reforms that were not convincing to the demonstrators. "We don't want neither Albasi nor Abdul Mahdi. We want to overthrow the regime," the protester said. The scene in the symbolic Tahrir Square in the center of the capital today was chaotic. Elsewhere, some pitched tents as volunteers began distributing food and water to protesters. It was also noted that large numbers of women and students descended into nearby squares. An implementation of a student sit-in included primary, middle and preparatory schools and even university students. Two elderly women, wearing black robes and covering their heads with a black veil, waved the Iraqi flag and swayed to the music and chants after standing on a concrete barrier. "I'm here for the future of children," said a girl who declined to be named. Next article of interest. Counterterrorism agency explains the reasons for its spread in Baghdad. Sunday, October 27, 2019, 1:34 a.m. Baghdad. Baghdad/the Iraqi Anti-Terrorism Service announced on Sunday the deployment of its forces in some areas of Baghdad under the guidance of the commander of the armed forces Adel Abdul Mahdi. In a statement received by Eye of Iraq News, the agency said that the forces of the counterterrorism spread in some areas of Baghdad, attributing the matter to protect the sovereign and vital installations from being tampered with by undisciplined elements taking advantage of the security forces' preoccupation with the protection of demonstrations and demonstrators. The statement said that the deployment came under the guidance of the commander-in-chief of the armed forces and the order of the head of the counterterrorism. The capital Baghdad and 9 other provinces have been witnessing since Friday, 25 October, demanding the dismissal of the government and holding the killers of the demonstrators accountable for violence against demonstrators, which resulted in the death and injury of thousands of demonstrators and members of the security forces. Next article of interest. Saleh discusses with UN representative election law and launching national dialogue to amend the constitution. October 27, 2019, 1652. The President of the Republic Barham Saleh, with the special representative of the Secretary-General of the United Nations, Jenan Hans Blaskart, discussed the draft election law and the launch of a national dialogue to amend the Constitution. A statement of his office, which received Euphrates News, said that during the meeting, discussed cooperation with the United Nations in the review of the electoral system. and also discuss the draft election law for the House of Representatives and the provincial and district councils and the Independent High Electoral Commission, which is hoped to be completed. The final will be soon by the presidential team, and the importance of securing the logistical support of the commission to hold the next elections. Saleh also reviewed the preparations for launching the draft national dialogue on the constitutional amendments that Iraqis and demonstrators look forward to as a way to reform the political process in Iraq, he stressed, stressing the importance of protecting public security and the right of Iraqis to demonstrate peacefully. For her part, Plaskart reaffirmed United Nations support for efforts to hold free and fair elections and to provide assistance and advice to strengthen the work of the Independent High Electoral Commission and its independent professional performance, stressing the need to protect peaceful demonstrators. Next article of interest, the rise of the number of resignation to 4 deputies and a member of the Provincial Council and a million demonstration in Baghdad. Baghdad, writings October 27, 2019. Officials at several government sites appear to have decided to join the demonstrators and support them in their legitimate demands for the restoration of Iraq's sovereignty and the fight against the corrupt who looted the country's good for nearly 16 years, in conjunction with the resignation of 4 parliamentarians. Sunday, October 27, 2019, Arshik Muzahim El-Tamimi, Raid Fahmy, Haifa Al-Amin and Taha Defense. Local sources said that a member of the Council of Najaf Province announced his resignation from his membership of the council in solidarity with the demonstrators. A member of the council, Winner Shaban, who announced to those close to him that the resignation comes out of respect for the blood of the martyrs and wounded after the uprising, which brought out all Iraqis under the banner of Iraq. In the meantime, the Iraqi capital and a number of provinces witnessed a rise in the number of demonstrators dramatically. While the rebels arrived in Tahrir Square in numbers approaching a million demonstration on Sunday evening, declaring their rejection of repression, killing and corruption. Next article of interest, Bahram Saleh holds an emergency meeting to discuss the dismissal of the government and the announcement of a transitional government. Baghdad Sky Press Sunday, October 7, 2019 at 14:48 p.m. The President of the Republic Bahram Saleh in the Palace of Peace in Baghdad. In the meantime, a meeting with a number of heads of blocs and the judiciary and representatives of the Kurdistan Alliance to discuss several options, including the dismissal of the government of Adel Abdul Mahdi and the declaration of an emergency government. A source familiar with the presidency said that the meeting began a hawala an hour from now to discuss meeting the demands of the demonstrators and a number of solutions, including the dismissal of the current government and the announcement of a government to lead the country in the transition. More articles of interest to come. Hit that subscribe button and the alert bell so you don't miss my next post. I encourage you, knowledge is power. Stay informed and stay alert. Over and out for now, the Dinarian.